No. I mean, I've talked to our players a lot the last 3 days about not falling into a routine, not taking things for granted. Not thinking that it's a birthright, because you know what it is it's a byproduct, I think, of being surrounded with good people and doing things the right way and having a level of commitment. And you know, at this day and time, a young person's got to work hard to be a good person. You know, that's not easy to do. Make a commitment to something. That's not easy to do. And then come in, you can call it whatever you want, 365 days a year, and do what you need to do to be a good player. Oh, well, this just happens. No, it doesn't. You know, it doesn't. It's what you work for. It's why you come to Georgia. It's part of why you come to Georgia. But you know, you look at that senior class, and Arias was four for them. They've done what they've had to do to be successful. So I don't ever take it for granted, and it's special. It's an honor. I mean, that number, the thing that puts it in perspective for me is there's roughly 300 teams not going. Mm-hmm. You say, oh, 64, that's a big number. So what? They got in. But 300 aren't. And those guys are sitting around wishing they could, wondering what they could do different, you know, wishing they had better teammates or wishing they had done something during the summer. And it makes this special. You know, I mean, you got kids in our conference. They've never played in a tournament. They're about to graduate. Mm-hmm. That makes it special. So you got to talk about that kind of stuff, and you got to think about that kind of stuff to appreciate this year. You know, because this is the only one we really got. This is the only one. We don't know what's going to happen next year. It's this year, you know, so it's special. And we've already sat in there and talked about it. We'd like to try to leave on Wednesday night late if we can get that arranged. Get out there and get acclimated on Thursday. Get a hard practice on Thursday, light practice on Friday, play on Saturday. We'll be in the office. John's already gone back. He's pulling down tape of Montana. You know, we'll be on that tonight. We could have the scouting report and plan ready by tomorrow, but I don't know that we'll do a whole lot tomorrow. I suspect we'll come in and shoot and go through some offensive stuff. I doubt that we'll do much tournament-wise because, you know, you think about the regular season. We play on Thursday and Sunday. We go Friday, Saturday prep, and we're good to go. I think you can do too much. Mm-hmm. You know, we start tomorrow. By Saturday, there's not going to be any sense of urgency. I think, you know, you can start things too early. It's kind of like Christmas shopping. You know, you lose the spirit for Christmas if you start shopping. Yeah, you're really in the spirit. You go out like day before Christmas. You know,
works for me.
Yeah, I mean, you feel it. You start in November, you don't feel it. And as successful there as we have anywhere. You know, so I don't mind it. The thing that I mind about it is that it makes it difficult for their families and our fans. Mm-hmm. And when I say difficult, most of them aren't going to be able to go. But moreover, it's hard to stay up and watch. You guys aren't going to have it in the paper the next day. They're not even going to be able to read about it. You know what I mean? So it's hard. That part I don't like. But the rest of it, you know, you get out there, you're by yourself, you can get focused, you don't have a lot of peripheral things.
I think it's something that you do take for granted. I mean, once you come to Georgia, it's just kind of something that's expected because of the tradition of being here. Like you said, 30 out of 32 years, I mean, yeah. It's what you do. But as you take a step back and I've looked at it the past couple of days, I realized how truly special it really is. I mean, you have some teams who are sitting around worried about if they were going to make it to the NCAA tournament. Then you have some teams that just had no hope of ball of making it, so their season has been done and, you know, the uniforms have been gone. And so you learn to kind of appreciate where you are and to enjoy the moment and accept that it's really something special. It really doesn't matter. I mean, it's just a great thing to be able to be in the tournament, period. So no matter where they send us, I feel like we all would have still been pretty excited about it. We're just looking forward to going out there and being able to play. I have not heard from them yet, but we did have a conversation about it earlier today of where they were having hopes that we would go. Definitely somewhere a little bit closer. Washington definitely probably would be out of the question. I remember we had to go down early to adjust to the time because we hadn't really had to deal with anything like that throughout the year. We went out to Mexico earlier this year. I mean, so we've had to deal with the time change a little bit, but nothing like what it's like on the West Coast. I remember the time change being a little bit different. It would be around 6 to 7 o'clock and everybody was tired and ready to go to bed, but we adjusted. And by the time that it was finally time to play and as we moved on to the Sweet 16, our bodies were just used. I don't think that it's something that we really think about much at all. I mean, at the end of the day, you still got to go out there and you have to play basketball. So more than anything, I think we just try to focus more on the matchup. Going out to the West Coast, I think, would be a fun experience for the freshmen who haven't ever really traveled, and especially for their first NCAA tournament. And I think it'll be good, too, for the seniors on our last NCAA tournament to get to travel out west as well. I'm excited to get back out on the court. I mean, it definitely didn't end the way that we wanted it to end in the SEC tournament, but we've had an opportunity to get in the gym and work on some things and try to become better individuals as well as a better team. And so I'm just ready to get back out there and see how it looks all put together.
It's a great feeling, you know. Growing up, you know, you watch the NCAA tournament the entire time, so it's just an honor to be playing in it this year. I don't think so. I mean, we had a pretty good season this year, so I think it was just more of an expectation for us to be back. This is Georgia's known for going to the tournament, you know, just making an appearance in general, so it's just a big thing.
How big is it?
It's huge. Like, it's just a great feeling to know that you're coming into a great program like this.